system to do multi-feature classification. Okay, so I'm going to walk you through a procedure I use to take a 10 different features and then calculate the age for an abalone based on rings. So we start off and we have a couple of functions. I found these on the website. One was time series to supervise. And what it's basically doing is taking your data and shifting it. So it shifts the data in terms of features. So you can think of the features as a set of arrays. So you'd have each set of 10 features would be an array list, and then you would stack those array lists into your inputs, and that gets fed into the LSTM. So you have your LSTM takes the shape of those inputs, and you're going to apply then the lag, which in this case the lag would be the number of features. So it works a lot like an LSTM when you're using time series, and that's why it was called the time series function. So the function is called time series to supervise. So it takes those different features, even though we're not dealing with a time series problem. We're going to treat the data like time series. So we're going to treat the features like they are a time series set. Okay, then we're going to use min max scalar to normalize data, so it smooths out the noise in the network and creates a more even distribution, so the things are coming in smoother. Okay, from the data you have length, diameter, height, hole weight, shuck weight, viscaria weight, shell weight, and rings. Now rings, you can divide that by 1.5 and that'll give you the age and years, and then we'll do a label encode that will convert the categories into numbers. Okay, once we have that, we have a nice set of a data set. So we'll take our raw values, we'll just get the data frame values, and we'll dump that into a series. Then we'll say pass the series and the number of features, and the features then become the lag. So what that does is it has the same effect as a time series. The lag will tell you the offset or the shift in the data that your data is going to be in. So the raw numbers are just like one long contiguous set of numbers, and then we're going to shift through that and we'll create the supervised. Now once we have that, we have array of arrays or list of lists, and we can then split the train size and split and test size, and we'll get a length on the train size and split side, and then we can just slice the supervised values, and we'll get the first part will be the train and the last remaining part will be the test. All right, so given that, now we can use an LSTM model, and we'll use the time steps is 24, features will be 9. That will give us the 10th one will be the target. Okay, so even though it said features above, it should have said columns. And then now in the LSTM, we have 9 features and the 10th one is our target. Okay, we'll set our learning rate, dropout rate, number of neurons in the LSTM, and the number of neurons in our dense layer is 200. Batch size will be 1. Activation will be relative RL. And then we'll pass in for our X, we'll pass in our rows and columns and our batch size for the batch input shape. And then we'll set our LSTM to the LSTM neuron count, which would be 256. And then you'll notice that we're going to set our activation to RLU, and then we're going to set up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. five dense layer networks, and with one output, which will be our age. Then for the model, loss model, we'll use the mean squared error, and then we'll use an atom optimizer. Okay, so then once we do that, we'll take our train and test data, we'll convert it into a scalar values for train scale and test scaled, and then we'll slice the train scaled values, and we'll get X train, which will be the values less less the target, and then we'll get the target value, and we'll do that. We'll reshape the X train, and so that it's in the rows, one batch, and columns, so it follows that format that we just talked about for the batch input to the LSTM. We'll repeat that same process for test, and then we will create our model, and then we'll fit our model. And so you can see that we have 98,000 parameters, and then we'll run the test, we'll get the summary, and then you can see the loss accuracy, the loss value. So gets kind of noisy here, and then it starts to settle down. The LSTM is kind of nice because it learns quickly. Dense layer here is picking up lots of features, and it's bouncing around a little bit trying to get the features correct. Okay, did try to implement here a algorithm for Keras classifier. I was looking for grid search to find the best algorithm, and looking to see if I could change some of the values in the different layers of the hidden network, and was unsuccessful to do that. So I got to work on that one to figure out what needs to be done.